I am Jerry Bradley Jr. This is Jerry Bradley III. This is our brethren from Cameroon and Bamalike Thomas. Yeah. And our younger brother,
Sietin,
and our brother Samuel. We are the Bamalike tribe. And we have found out that Jerry, my son, and I have found that we are members of the Bamalike tribe. And it was from Cameroon that our ancestors were taken by the European slave masters. So that's what we're excited about. And we want everyone to know that that has completed our journey from slavery, psychological, mental slavery, to liberation. And we will be going home soon to connect with the rest of our family members. Jerry.
Ashe.
Jerry.
We are very excited to reconnect with my brother, Thomas, brother Samuel. Just the words are not sufficient to be able to express what's going on and what we're feeling inside. We're trying to do our best to, you know, to lay out the fact that what the journey that that I've been on through the fact that I was able to use the technology that exists today to where we can actually trace through our DNA, which is used to free our African-American brothers from bondage in prison, in our prison industrial complex in this country, through DNA. So it's a very reliable system, and that system has allowed me to be able to pinpoint the exact place and tribe that we come from. And what that does for us to recognize that, number one, when I started studying about our culture, one thing to find out that we are biologically connected and biologically related to ancient Israelite Jewish people.
Exactly.
That is a real
yes.
biological and cultural connection that we have. Every custom that is in the Bamalike custom with family, all that is tied directly into historical Hebraic way of life.
Exactly.
Even I realized in the research that they even call the Bamalike the Jews of Africa.
Yes.
So to confirm, because that was actually more validation for other research that I had been revealed to me about our ancestry. So the thing I want people to know is that what we want to do is make it physically back home.
Right.
Because psychologically, yes. emotionally, and culturally, we're going.
Yes.
We're there.
We're there already.
We're there. As a matter of fact, as soon as that report came back, I went right home. Right here. As soon as that report came back that I was a Bamalike, I connected immediately to it.
Yes.
So it's just a matter of putting the physical feet on ground, mm-hmm. back home, going to our physical chief or fund, and getting our names
yes.
back,
yes.
giving our names to who we really are.
Right.
And when I read about the mentality and the strength and the determination, the self-determination of the Bamalike,
yes.
I know that's us.
That's us.
We've always stood out.
Yeah.
In our own families, we've
right.
always stood out
right.
as not being the person that just get along and go along,
mm-mm.
as always being the person with determination and focus to get things done the way we know they need to be done,
right.
with truth and honesty and
yes.
justice.
Yes.
So that's something that I feel already emanates from us.
Yes.
All I need to do was get the title to apply to it.
Exactly.
We were already had the characteristics
right.
of who we are. We're just now getting the titles revealed.
Yes.
So to be able to have somebody here like Brother Thomas and you
Samuel.
Yes. That you can allow us to even more insight. I was saying, anybody that is out there that is a part of the Bamalike clan, we want to connect with you. We want us to we need to bring a community together, because that's really I know we can't get it all from books. I can't read about who I am or being a part of our culture. I need to experience it with my family members. So that's our desire. Until we can get to our physically get to the ground in Africa, in Cameroon, and go and reconnect ourselves, get our name back, this is what we're going to be trying to do. So that way, when we get there, we definitely won't feel out of place.
Right.
So ultimately, this has just been a journey to trying to fill up some void spaces that's in the minds of most Black Americans.
Yes.
We have a serious void. And every organization that tries to tackle our problems and say what we need to do. The issue is culture.
That's right.
Everything that we need is wrapped up in our culture. Economics, family, how to raise your children, nutrition, friendships, all that is wrapped up in our culture.
Worship.
Respect, worship, all in the culture.
Right.
So if we can start establishing a culture, recognize the difference between our culture and what European culture is, and see that we've adopted European white culture unknowingly, and now we didn't have any choice, but now we have a choice.